This is Elliott Antman. I'm the president-elect of the American Heart Association. There's been a lot of discussion in the medical literature about the importance of sodium in our diet. We do know that there is a relationship between the amount of sodium that a person eats and the likelihood that they will develop hypertension. The American Heart Association strongly believes that lowering the sodium intake in our diet is a very important method by which we can control hypertension and reduce cardiovascular morbidity and mortality. We are publishing today in proceedings of the American Heart Association Sodium Conference that took place in June 2013. This was a very important conference where we had 128 stakeholders who gathered in Arlington, Virginia. These stakeholders were from the food manufacturing domain, those interested in food research, those interested in regulatory and legislative activities related to food, public health, those involved in health care, and the scientific research related to nutrition and health. We had a number of very interesting presentations that involved some of the scientific data related to sodium and its relationship to blood pressure. We also had some reports on the consumer opinions about sodium in their diet. We heard some perspectives from the food industry, and we had a number of very interesting discussions about the impact of lowering sodium in our food supply. We recognize that there's a very important problem here, since about 75% of the sodium we eat in the course of a day comes from the supermarket foods that we purchase or the restaurant foods that we go out to eat when we have a restaurant meal. The American Heart Association continues to recommend that the sodium intake should be less than 1,500 milligrams per day from all sources. The scientific basis for this, the regulatory and legislative implications of that, are all discussed in the proceedings of our American Heart Association Sodium Conference.